good to
I
go.
I love like the monochromatic look with the pop of color. Yes, it's so good.
Thank
Great.
You. Thank you very
I'm
much.
Going to
this
style
was...
my husband
just like that.
Just like that.
I need more people to agree with you. And I do much better on the London dating scene. I think this was purely an accident, but thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Keisha Jordana, hello. Good morning.
Good
Welcome
morning.
To London.
Thank you.
How are you enjoying over in the UK at the moment?
Love it.
It's barely rained, I think, in the last
yeah,
couple of days.
Yeah, just a little.
We've got
nice.
Some LA
yeah.
weather. LA weather's probably
lots
a little bit.
Lots of daylight over here.
Too much. Have you guys been here before? I'm presuming you've been here with Fast
yes,
a number of times.
Yes, and I lived here as a little girl. I went to school here.
Really?
My sister was born here. So, yeah, it's
whereabouts?
Really nice.
Like around London?
Mm-hmm. Oh. I went to Glendower.
Glendower.
Yeah, it's an all-girls school.
Okay, well, I'm northern, so I
okay.
barely know my way
okay.
around, like, Oxford Circus, to be fair. But that's interesting. Have you ever been over here before?
A year ago, April, I was here. And it didn't rain at all. I was here for, like, a week, and it was sunny the whole time. So.
Guys, I mean, I think it's a rumour that it rains a lot
I
in,
know,
in England,
it's
really. I mean, I've not seen rain in about 4 years. So I think it's
Lies.
Just, we just say it for tourism more than anything. Guys, Lethal Weapon.
Yes.
Lethal Weapon. I don't know, like, I don't know whether you guys were big fans of the movies back in the day.
Oh, yes.
But you must have understood the sort of kind of the pressure of getting a show like this right.
For sure. We absolutely did. We were fans of the films. So when we heard they were making it into a TV series, we thought, like most people, leave it alone. Why? It will fail. It's a
yeah.
stupid idea.
Who wants to take that?
Leave Mel alone. Yeah. But then we
I don't
read...
think anyone's been saying leave Mel alone yeah. for a little while, to be fair.
That's another interview.
That's another day.
Yeah. But we read the script and we knew it was special. That's when I wanted to be a part of it after I read the script. I was like, oh my gosh. And I love the franchise. I want to be a part of this TV series.
I mean, it's interesting that we're talking about it now, 13 episodes in
okay,
over here in the UK.
13,
we're 13
yes.
in. I say we.
Yes.
I've seen them all already.
Oh, have you?
And
cool.
So, and I can say that the last two episodes, I think, are the best two episodes.
Yes.
So if that's not reasons to carry on watching, I don't
yes,
know what it is.
Yes, yes.
But you're right. There's this kind of wave of kind of bringing stuff back. I mean, when I heard about like Rush Hour coming back
yeah,
a year ago and Lethal
right.
Weapon, I was
yeah.
like,
ooh,
but
yeah.
at the end of the day, a year later, no one's talking about Rush Hour.
Yeah.
Everyone's talking about Lethal
yeah.
Weapon.
The reason why is because our two, Riggs and Roger, they're not trying to imitate Mel and Danny. And I think that's where they went wrong with Rush Hour is they were doing an imitation of those characters.
No, they're so charismatic and they
yeah,
bring something
they bring
so new to
so
it.
So new, so mm-hmm. different, just as great. And I think that's why we succeeded.
The interesting thing is there was this huge international audience for like the brand and the idea of Lethal Weapon.
Yeah.
And that's kind of transposed into the TV series.
Yeah.
I was seeing you guys were doing like a Q&A yesterday and there's all these like names popping up like Lethal Weapon India,
yes.
Lethal Weapon Canada. If I don't know if copyrights like have been a problem there or
no,
anything, but everyone's just jumping on it from all
it's
over
really
the place.
Cool.
It's number one in 21 countries. Number
well,
one.
There you
TV.
Go.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's, really
that's
cool.
how you know how successful the films were because it makes people curious. So we get that audience of curiosity, and we keep that audience because the show is so good.
The chemistry of the cast was going to be massively important. The huge difference between, you know, a film, then another film, then another film, and a series, especially in the States, which can be like 18, 22, 24 episodes,
yeah.
hours and hours of TV every
yep.
year. You need an ensemble cast. You need to
they
give a lot
along.
Of time to the people.
Yeah.
And that's where you guys have stepped in. Trish is obviously a character we've known from the films, but
mm-hmm.
that was a very,
different.
Maybe 1980s Trish, like a housewife. Whereas this time you guys have had a free rein in a way to create these characters. Has that
yes.
been, you know, that must have been part of the attraction.
For sure.
Mm-hmm.
And I think when we read the script, we saw that Matt wasn't like, he just, there wasn't, Lethal Weapon, I think the title gives you so much because it's like a built-in audience and the buddy cop
mm-hmm.
genre is great. But then I think Matt ran with that and created his own thing, which is very cool. And with Maureen Cahill is there's another character called Marianne who's a doctor, but my character's not based on her at all. So we do have a lot of freedom to play. And I think that'll be even more true in season two, which
mm-hmm.
is lovely.
There are some similarities with the series and the films.
Yes.
As you know, as fans of the films, is there anything you guys would like to bring back at all?
The toilet scene.
Toilet scene was one of the best
the
scenes.
The best
I
scenes
think.
Ever. I would love to see that. With a little twist, I don't know what that twist would be, so it'll be a little different, but I would love to see that scene.
Hi.
Oh my God!
Yay! Zane's got a great voice.
I'll just leave it at that.
I've wanted to meet you.
Oh,
we haven't met each other yet.
Got some lipstick on your teeth.